Hello everyone, in this tutorial we will add a joystick to this mobile space shooter game. As you can see, I can move the spaceship by moving this virtual joystick. By the way, if you want to learn how to make mobile games for Android and iOS, I have a great new course, so check the link in the description. Back to the joystick implementation. We will use a new input system. First, we need to go to Package Manager. Make sure you select Unity Registry. Then search for the input system. Select it and click on the Install button. I have already done that. Then right-click on the project window, Create, Input Action. I will call it Controls. Click on the Edit Asset button. This will open a new tab. Click on the plus button to create a new action map. This action map will be for the player, so call it Player. Then we have actions. Actions can be, for example, shooting, movement, and so on. Every action has one or more bindings. Bindings are like triggers. We determine what button we need to press to activate the action. I will just delete this action to show you the process. To create a new action, click on this plus button. This action will be for movement, so call it Move. You can see action properties here. We need to change the action type. For the joystick, we don't need a button, we need to use value. Also, we need to set the control type to any value or use vector2. Then select the binding and open Path. Open Gamepad and select left stick. Now, when we are done, it's important to save the asset. If you make some changes, remember to save it. Then select the player. We need to add a player input component. Then drag in the asset controls that we made. Now let's create the UI for the joystick. We need one image. I call it left stick. Go to the scene view. Select the image. I will just zoom in a little bit. If you want to have a joystick in the bottom left corner, then we need to change anchor preset and pivot point to the bottom left corner. Hold Shift and Alt and choose the bottom left corner. We can change the position a bit. Then let's add the on-screen stick component. For the control path, choose the same path as we did in our controls, and that is the left stick. Let's test this. You can see that the image is behaving like a joystick, but nothing happens. The player is not moving. Before we deal with that, let's adjust the joystick a bit. Move it more to the corner. Then let's change the image. See the link in the description for more virtual joystick images. We can also increase the scale a bit. This looks better. Notice there is the movement range variable. It determines how far the joystick will move from its center. Let's increase it to 100. This is much better. Also, to make UI compatible and scalable for all devices, we need to select Canvas. Then change Scale Mode to scale with screen size. Then set reference resolution. Let's match width and height equally, so set this to 0.5. All we have to do now is to connect the joystick with player movement. Let's select the player. I have the player controls script. Let's open it. You can ignore the variables and functions you see. I use them for something else in the mobile course. To make the joystick work, first, we need to create one input action reference. back in Unity, expand the controls asset, you can see action move, drag it in the empty field, go back to the script. We will need one float variable speed. Then in update, let's use vector 2 for the direction. We will get the direction values from input action reference. So use move action to use that action that read value. Sticks on gamepads have vector 2 values. That means that we read value vector 2. To actually move the player, use transform.translate. We multiply the move direction vector with the speed variable and then multiply everything with time.deltaTime for smooth movement. That is all we need to code. Back in Unity, don't forget to set the speed. Let's try it. Now you can see as I move the joystick, the player moves. Nice. That is all for this tutorial and see you in the next one.